Welcome to Max in 5. I'm going to teach you some cool stuff inside 3ds Max in under 5 minutes. I want to teach you the absolute mode transform typing inside 3ds Max. Big word, what is it for? This will allow you to actually move something inside 3ds Max accurately 100%. So let's first figure out what it does and where it is. If I select my object over here, this button right over here, absolute mode transform typing, and then three numbers. Now at the moment they are 000. If I move the object in the Y, notice how the Y is moving and that number moves. It is telling me that this object is exactly negative 2809 to the center of Max. See this grid over here? See that center point? That is the 000 space. Now, if I move the object in the X, that number also changes. So now we know that the object is this number and that number away from the center of Max. Now, of course, if I move the Z, it'll go up, and now I've got three numbers. So it is important to know one thing. These numbers represent where the pivot point is to the center of Max. Pivot points are different in all objects, depending where you have manipulated them or where they have been created from. Right now, this box is center to the bottom. So if I right-click on any of these arrows, you'll see that it will reset to zero, moving the object, obviously, back to the zero space. So remember, the absolute mode transform typing is telling us where the object is and how far it is away from the center of Max. But there's a great function with this. Let's go into a real world scenario. Let's activate our camera. Now you would like to move this object in the Y 100 units in that direction. Now, of course, what you can simply do is just having a look at these three numbers. We know that this number is representing where the pivot point is to the center of Max. If I click and hold in and just simply drag in the direction that I want and slowly going and hoping to get to 100, it's going to take a little bit of time and I'm 6 units out. In my case, 6 millimeters. And then that's fine. That's as close as I can get. Wrong. You can get closer. Let's undo that. I'm going to isolate this to make our lives a bit easier. The best way to do a movement like this when you want to be accurate is to activate the absolute mode transform typing. Now, it's important to note, as I activate this button, these three numbers are gonna go to zero. Why is that? Max has given you the opportunity to be 100% accurate and to say to you, fine, here's your object, let's zero everything out. And now, how far do you wanna move the object and in what direction? So now, I can simply come here, type 100, press enter. Important to note before I press enter button, the number is not going to show 100. It is going to go back to zero. As I press enter, it moved the 100 units. It stayed at zero. Really important to know, because now I can go another 100 units if I want by pressing the enter button. Here's another example. I select this object over here and I've got these three numbers and they're too big for me to calculate. If I wanted to just move the object something like 30, 40, 50, 60, even something like 65 units in any direction. Activating the absolute mode transform typing resets that to zero. I can move this in 65. And remember, as I press enter, it goes back to zero, because then I can move it another number that I want. And I can move it in small increments until I'm happy with it. And the last tip is that the absolute mode transform typing actually works with the rotate tool as well. And this is a great way to actually rotate your object in increments if you want. So make sure you activate the absolute mode transform typing, select that. I'm going to choose 25 degrees, press enter. It rotated 25, reset back to zero, allowing me to go in another increment. I could go in another 10 degrees and press enter. One more tip, using the three numbers at the bottom, if you select the object, you can see where it was rotated. If it is rotated in a very strange number, you can simply come here, press zero. It will reset it back to the 0 degree, allowing you to actually rotate the object, knowing that it's in the 5 degree intervals, making it a lot straighter and making you a lot accurate as an artist. And if you are looking for a full comprehensive course that teaches 3ds Max from the absolute beginning, for the archivist industry, check out my course at viscourse.com.